After successfully completing this lesson, you should be familiar with the sequence to follow at the end of discharge. To gain maximum benefit from this lesson, you should successfully have completed the previous lessons. This lesson explains the correct sequence to follow as the discharge comes to an end. The practical section consists of two parts. First, there is a demonstration of the procedures. This is followed by an interactive, guided walkthrough of the same procedures. At the end of discharge, the cargo pump must be carefully monitored and tended. In order to avoid the pump running dry or drawing air through a vortex, the hydronic pressure must be reduced as the tank nears completion. Warning signs include vibration in the pump, hunting, characterized by the needle rising and falling rapidly on the hydraulic pressure gauge, and, if the pump does lose suction, a distinctive surging noise from the pump itself. Good communication between an officer in the cargo control room and a watchkeeper on deck is essential. Please note that this chapter should be read in conjunction with Chapter 7, Stripping. You will now see a demonstration of the procedure to be followed at the end of discharge. Click on the buttons in numerical order. When the cargo tank is empty, the hydraulic pressure will fall to 50 to 100 bar. Close the cargo discharge valve. Stop the pump by opening the local control valve. Put the pump control handle on the Framo control panel to the minimum position. You will now take part in an interactive